Well, that's what I've been trying to make you understand. I have reviewed it. I've been over this contract with a fine-tooth comb, and it's binding.
Wayne, there are always loopholes.
Well, you're welcome to look for it.
Well, we already did.
Yes, but we're not lawyers. You are. So what do we have here?
Ned, it's a straightforward agreement. Look at it. It runs a page and a half, and the terms of the partnership are clearly spelled out. 60% ownership to Sonny Corinthos, 20 each to Lois and Brenda. You do the math.
No! I will not have my wife stuck in a partnership with Sonny Corinthos.
Hey! What about creative control?
What about it?
It's mine. I was adamant about that.
Exactly. Can't we do something with that?
Not as it applies to the issue of ownership. When you gave away 60% of your company to Sonny Corinthos, you gave away the power. You can't vote him out. You can't kick him out. He's holding all the cards.
Where is this defeatist attitude coming from? You're a Quartermain attorney. Now, you know as well as I do that there are ways to get people out of companies.
Well, you're welcome to try and find one.
Why the hell do you think you're here?
Ned, I can't wave a magic wand over this contract and invalidate it. Obviously, Sonny is a very intelligent businessman.
Now, Sonny is a street thug. And if his lawyers, if his slimy lawyers could put together a deal that your prestigious, hotshot, expensive law firm can't figure out a way to break, you're about to lose a major cash cow. Now, am I making myself perfectly clear?
I hear you. I still can't make this contract invalid.
All right. What if we dissolve L&B?
What? No!
Hypothetically.
Under New York state law, a partner must own two-thirds of the partnership in order to dissolve it, which none of you has, including Corinthos. Then again, since you two ladies are the day-to-day general managers, you could perform your duties in such a flagrantly slipshod manner as to render the enterprise non-viable.
No. What? No, we couldn't do that. It wouldn't be fair to our artists.
Let's sit on it a while. Well, maybe we can do something with that creative control clause after all.
Good, good. That's what I wanted to hear. At least it's a place to start. Thank you for coming over so quickly, Wayne. I appreciate it. And I apologize for being a little testy, but as you can see, the situation is a little out of hand.
I understand. I'll call you in a couple of days.
All right.
All right.
This is a nightmare. We're trapped.
No, we're not. We're going to get rid of Sonny one way or another.
I cannot even believe that it's come to this. I mean, do you guys remember when we first started this company?
Can I tell you something, Brenda? I admire the hell out of you.
Why?
Because this is such an unspeakably awful situation for you. And you're handling it with more grace and dignity than most people can muster up in a lifetime. Thanks. But
I don't think I really deserve any medals. Because if you guys want to know the truth, I'm screaming so loud inside right now, it blows me away that people can't hear it.
I'm back.
What's up with the surprise lift?
You didn't tell them I was back? I thought you told your little pals everything. Did I miss anything while I was gone?
Only the fact that you're not welcome here, Sonny.
Okay, here we go. I'm not even in the door for 2 minutes. You're already flapping your jaws.
You have no role with L&B anymore.
Well, see, that's where you're wrong, Ned. My role hasn't changed. And as a matter of fact, I don't recall seeing your name anywhere on the partnership agreement.
Yeah, well, did you see mine? Did you see Brenda's? We want you out.
Can she speak for herself?
I think Lois told you how I feel about it.
Right. Well, I'm not going to be able to help you ladies with that. See, I happen to enjoy owning a record label. It looks good on my resume. So we're going to have to just figure out a way to work together, just like we did when I wanted Ned gone and you guys wouldn't budge.
You can't even compare the two.
I can if I want to. The way I see it, they're both about perceived betrayal.
Not perceived. At least Ned told us the truth.
Yeah, right. When he was good and busted. Some paragon of virtue.
Don't try to make this about me. I didn't do anything life-threatening.
All right. I can see we're not getting anywhere today, so everyone's just going to have to live with this arrangement for a minute before we get on with things. So I'll go ahead and get out of your way for now.
Oh, by the way, since we're all so big on honesty around here, why don't you go ahead and ask Brenda what's going on between her and Miguel?
Between you and Miguel. I've got a need-to-know situation on my hands here.
Miguel and I are friends.
Yes, I already know that part.
Miguel and I are friends who just happen to be sleeping together at the moment.
Holy Toledo! Brenda! Is that why you guys were giggling when I asked you how rehearsals were going?
Yes.
How does Sonny know?
Well, maybe because it's absolutely impossible to keep a secret in this town.
Is that your answer?
If you must know.
Yes, I must know.
Okay. Miguel and I were taking a shower together at Kelly's. We came out of the bathroom wearing towels and bumped right into Sonny and Lily, fresh from their Puerto Rican adventure.
That is so nice, Brenda.
How are we supposed to know that they were going to be there together?
I can understand you're needing to be with someone right now. But Miguel?
What's wrong with it? We care about each other, and it just so happens that we both were just dumped by people who are supposed to love us. Look, if it makes us feel better to hang out with each other, then why shouldn't we?
Because unfortunately, it is not just about the two of you, okay? We've got an already volatile business situation on our hands, and this is not going to make it any better. No wonder Sonny was so jangly.
Where are you going?
Oh, I'm going to diffuse this.
You are not going to see Sonny alone.
I am not parading around town with a line of people following me. I will be fine.
Don't yell at me.
What are you using for brains?
If you think that I'm going to stand here while you jump all over my case about Miguel, you can think again.
I'm not. Because I understand. I really do. Your whole world has been rocked off its foundation. And I would never presume to tell you how to cope with it. I do wish you would come to me or Lois for consolation. But I can certainly see where what Miguel has to offer might address your needs more directly.
That's right. Miguel accepts me exactly the way I am. And I'm just beginning to realize that I missed that. You know, with Sonny, I could never do anything quite right. He always made me feel like I was letting him down somehow.
Have you thought about how Sonny's going to respond to this?
Oh, well, do you think that Sonny thought about me before he took off to Puerto Rico with Lily?
Well, I was actually thinking about what he might do to Miguel.
What do you mean?
Well, look at it from Sonny's point of view. Triple betrayal. First the wire, then L&B demands that he resign, and now you're having an affair with Miguel. Do you honestly believe that this is going to be okay with a wise guy like Sonny?
I thought we were finished with the business of the day.
Not quite.
We'll make it fast and busy.
This is insane, Sonny. We can't do this. I want you to reconsider your position and get out of L&B.
It's not gonna happen.
Sonny?
Forget about it. There's no way am I resigning.
I wouldn't give any of you the satisfaction. Secondly, I put a lot of Dosky into L&B, and I intend to be here when the returns come in. Now, I am sure that the quartermain attorneys have been burning the midnight oil, crawling all over our contract. And I'm equally sure they've told you it's airtight. So I am so sorry, but this partnership is a fact of your life. Learn to live with it.
I knew you were going to say that.
Then why are we here wasting everybody's time?
Because if this is a fact of life, and I'm not saying that I accept that it is, we got to find ways of incorporating it because we can't spend every minute of every day we are forced to be together yelling at each other.
I don't need to yell.
Then you agree that we need to establish a few ground rules.
What do you have in mind?
I want you to stay away from Brenda and Miguel. I mean it, Sonny.
Oh, no problem. If I don't see either of them again in my life, it will suit me fine.
Are you saying that you think that Sonny would hurt Miguel?
We all know about Sonny and violence. And if he's angry enough, there's no telling what he might do to any of us.
Well, we just have to keep our distance from him. Right? I mean, that's just what we'll do. I don't know exactly how we're going to do that after what your attorney said.
No, but he was onto something. See, if we can figure out a way to maneuver Sonny into infringing on Lois's creative control, he'd be in violation of his contract.
No. Ned, please, you're not giving Sonny enough credit. Sonny is very smart. And he's going to know that we're up to something, and he's going to be on guard.
Then we'll just have to be smarter than he is. After all, we are operating at an advantage.
And what would that be?
We're not coming from a place of ego. Spin it any way you want. The bottom line is, Sonny lost his woman to another guy. And not just any guy. A guy he has never liked in the first place. Which most of his animosity will now be focused on him. Maybe we can construct a situation that forces Sonny to cross the line with Miguel.